Hey guys, what's going on? Inception here, and welcome to another video. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new gameplay objective card that released today. And in all fairness, ladies and gentlemen, he actually looks like a pretty solid card for what he offers in game. So we are taking a look at a card that is 5'7", which isn't a great height, but he's more of an attacker, so not a huge deal, right? High work rates, right-footed, 4-star skill moves, and a 4-star weak foot. Now, the thing that you notice right away with this card is the base card stats, right? He actually has 76 defending with 82 physical, right? So we're going to take a look at the specifics with this card. He does also have the outside foot shot trait as well as leadership. More importantly, the outside foot shot trait, right? So very, very good that he has that as well. But it's the in-game specifics that we're going to be taking a look at because... I mean, he looks like a freaking monster, okay? 98 acceleration, 98 sprint speed. You don't need to improve that. It's upgraded perfectly with this card. In regards to shooting, he has 99 attacking positioning, but 84 finishing. So obviously with 84 finishing and dribbling stats like that, you still want to give him the sniper chemistry style, guys. What is this channel without the sniper chemistry style? You know what I mean? So a plus 15 for that finishing when he already has 98 shot power. You're going to boost his composure from an 82 to an 87. And you're also going to be boosting the reactions, ball control, and dribbling by a little bit as well. So sniper, right off the bat, is the card you're going to want to use because you want to make his finishing as perfect as possible. If you want to take more specific shots, but as you guys know in FIFA, the shooting is very linear in regards to consistency anyways, right? So 98 shot power, 88 long shots, 82 composure, blah, blah. Sniper chemistry style makes the most sense, right? A good thing about this card too is the fact that his passing stats for base card stats are good as well. You don't need to improve it, right? Dribbling stats. Base card stats, again, very good dribbling stats. Very, very good because he's a 5'7" player. So whatever gameplay you play in, this card is going to compensate really well for you and move around really quickly, okay? So very, very important there. In regards to defending, my boy actually gave him the defensive card. Now, I'll explain to you why. I think this is the... I don't know which one it is. It's a gladiator. I think it's a gladiator where he gives him shooting and defense, right? Okay. So here's the reason why he uses this card, and it's an actual pretty good reason to use this chemistry style on him, okay? So let's explain it. Look at his defensive stats, right? We're going to go on Footbin, and we're actually going to check out his in-game stats over here with the upgrade because I want you guys to take a look at something when it comes to a card like this. So with the gladiator chemistry style upgrade, the only thing that he's lacking in is defensive awareness. But take a look at his interceptions, heading accuracy, standing tackles, sliding tackles. It's really, really good with all the improvements on the card, right? But then you're also giving him a shooting boost. He doesn't necessarily need the dribbling boost because of the height that he actually has in game. Doesn't need the passing boost. Doesn't necessarily need a physical boost. So the reason why he adds this chemistry style to this card is because he's a card you can use in most of the positions, right? You can use him in the left attacking mid, center attacking mid, right attacking mid, striker. One of your CDMs as a more attacking oriented one because of that 99 attacking positioning. You can use him as a fullback with a chemistry style like this as well. Like, there's so much you can do with a card like this. His thought process for putting this chemistry style on this card is using him in the right center mid position. And honestly, I agree with him. He's going to be more of an attacking-oriented center mid in the right position, but he's definitely going to offer you this presence where, again, he's just a really good rotational player. These types of cards are always welcome improvements because they're really sick. He had a card before, if I remember correctly, and it was like the Confederations one. It was like the brown color, right? Which was this one right here. Sorry, I'm looking at my main screen like a dumbass. But you can see here that this is the card that I'm talking about. And even this card with the sniper chemistry style was actually incredibly usable in game, so very, very important in regards to that as well. But we are going to be trying him on the gladiator, or the gladiator. We'll be able to see what his dribbling is like without the gladiator, because like I said, it might be more ideal to just give him the gladiator and not improve his dribbling on the team of the season version of the card, because his dribbling stats for base card stats already look really good. So I'll let you guys know if you need the dribbling improvement, because it is 336 right now, so gameplay is always terrible this time. So we'll be able to test him out in that. So the way that we are going to be lined up with this card in my team is going to look like this. We'll be using the 3 and 6 depths, 3 and 6 for that. balance, perfect. We're going to be using him in the right attacking position at first, and then we're going to keep constantly rotating him just because you can with a card like this. We're going to have balance on him. No conservative, because a card like this has 99 stamina, so we're not doing any sort of conservative on this card. Neymar, we're going to have on normal, and then Belotti has good off the ball movement, so we'll keep him on normal as well. So I just want to see how he's going to move in the attacking areas, whether or not he actually does the cut inside mechanic, because obviously for me, I love players that do that. But I mean, a card like this with defensive stats like that, I could already see him being used in a potentially like a right mid position as well in a three at the back formation, just because you have that balance of pushing forward and coming back, right? So this is a good gameplay objective card for the type of team of the season that was released. Another one I give EA credit for, because the stats look great for what they're offering in game, right? The upgrades that you're giving this card are significant enough with two different chemistry styles to make him really good. So we're gonna get into a game, see how he plays, and we'll go from there. Oh, this is I always like seeing teams like this. It's a little bit different, you know, like not the typical meta. He's got Jota in there. He's got Daniel James, Madison chilling in there too. It's a nice team. I like it. You know what's good so far is that he actually doesn't seem that tiny in game, because his body type is a little bit wide. So it actually kind of helps out a lot. He doesn't feel like a mini me on the pitch, right? Like if you actually take a look at the way that he looks on the pitch, he doesn't look like a card like Nakajima, for instance. Like Nakajima is tiny and it actually is noticeable, right? But it doesn't feel like it's too noticeable on this card, which is great. I mean, already showing a solid defensive presence right there in the on the sides. Really nice there. Aggressive right there, which is great. That's perfectly fine, because I was making that specific pass to kind of open up the space there. So pretty nice so far. But I mean, the Gladiator is definitely one of the cards that could make a lot of sense for a card like this. Neymar with crazy off the ball movement. I made a better pass. Would have been nice there. Look at how fast he gets back into position when I don't have comeback and defense on him. That's nice, man. Nice. Base card stats for pace is really good on this card. Oh, I really wanted to try a shot from that angle. So I'm going to say this right now, right? Now, obviously for the rotation policy in regards to changing your formations constantly, he'll definitely be really nice to use with the Gladiator chemistry style. But if you are going to be attacking with him, or you want to specifically attack with him and your team in a nice little 4-2-3-1 system, you have to give him the sniper chemistry style. I'm sorry, but it's just the way the state of this game is. You definitely just need it, because look at the way that this card attacks into empty space, right? A sniper chemistry style on him with improved dribbling abilities is the most ideal situation for me personally, if you're going to be using him in the attack. But if you're going to always constantly rotate your team, it does also make sense to just give him the Gladiator chemistry style as well, right? So you can see that he actually does the cut inside mechanic as well, and it was really noticeable that he was doing that in that one attacking area where he almost scored. So very, very important there. You can see his off the ball movement in this situation, very good. Rotates to his left foot, scores the opportunity. Nice little finish right there. So this is one of those, it was very obvious with this card, right? This is one of those cards where he's just like an ultimate team card. You know what I'm saying? Like a card that, real life to ultimate team, completely different. Because apparently this dude is like 35 years old, but he has like 99 stamina. He's got all the right stats in all the right places. Again, it's a great gameplay objective card, but he's a foot card, you know? So I'm enjoying it so far in the right attacking mid position. The thing that I'm liking the most with this card is the fact that his height is not affecting my opinion on the card, because sometimes when players just feel too small in game, it's just not ideal, right? But he doesn't feel too small, which is really nice. He actually feels like a 5 foot, I'd say like a 5'9" player, if anything. The fact that he has base card stats of pace is just really nice. Little flick. Gonna hold off the player here. Fake shot stop. Try a shot across goal. Yeah, so right there, obviously, sniper chemistry style. You want to be able to have that on the player so that you can potentially score across goal. Now, and like I keep telling you guys in multiple reviews, right? When it comes to the finishing, that's just not one of the specific ways to score, unfortunately, right? So he's just not gonna consistently hit those into the back of the net, right? So even with the sniper, he could potentially just hit it into the middle. It's just how it is in this game. See, so I pressed circle to tackle there, and because they're both the same commands, he actually just kicked the ball away anyways. But, I mean, you guys can see just in that situation right there, his defensive presence is really, really nice with the gladiator chemistry style. So it's definitely a combination of what you want your player to do, right? Like, his dribbling is not awful, but again, if you're going to be using him in the attack, I think you want to improve his dribbling and his finishing as much as possible. But, I mean, his dribbling is already pretty good because of the height that he has in game, right? Just the way that he moves into empty space quickly is so nice. You see how he started to cut inside right there instantly? I was waiting for him to do that with Belotti, right? But in those situations, players don't often trigger it really quickly. So I felt like it was actually really good that he was doing that pretty fast. It's really obvious, guys, that his off-the-ball movement is really, really good, like on the sides. I don't think I need to experiment with that anymore. Some players just feel very linear in regards to playing in those positions, and he's definitely not that type of card. He actually feels really nice there, and I think with the sniper, it would be like significantly better. So we're gonna go ahead and actually switch him to the cam spot, and we're gonna see how he plays with his high work rates there. How do you move over here? Okay, I need he stops. Good. It's exactly what I want him to do there. Little body feint, ball roll touch, ball roll touch. There you go. I want a little bit. I want a little bit more responsiveness. I'm a freak, guys. It's because of the gameplay. What do you guys want me to say, man? If the gameplay wasn't like this, I just want a little bit more responsiveness, okay? But, I mean, dudes, this is a good gameplay objective card. Like, he's really nice, man. But he needs a sniper. He needs it. Oh, he's so aggressive, dude. He's so aggressive, man. He just sprints forward in that situation. Hey, man. It makes for random play, you know? He doesn't sprint forward like Julian Brandt does or, you know, Yuri Litmanen's card does. The way he sprints just makes sense. Like, over here, I want you to do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, that specific sprint right there, I expect that from him. But I do expect him to make a run into the middle here, too. Yes. And I don't have the sniper. I want you guys to remember that. I don't have the sniper chemistry style on him, right? So, in the attacking areas, you gotta give him the sniper. But, dudes, I mean, he's a foot card. That's what he is, man. He's a foot card. I feel like, I don't know, man. It feels like they've been paying attention more in regards to what gameplay objective cards, what SBC cards they should be releasing because of the way that their upgrades work. Because a card like this, there's two chemistry styles you give him. And if you give him those two chemistry styles, he's incredibly usable. Like, this is a really cool card to get from a gameplay objective. Like, hey, I hate your gameplay, guys, but menu guys, you guys have been impressing me. I'm not gonna lie. I'm really liking him in the cam spot, guys. It actually reminds me of Lucas Moura's moments card in the cam position. A little bit more aggressive, actually, than a Lucas Moura cam card, which I like Lucas Moura a tiny bit more for. A tiny bit, but this card's wild, dude. This is not a card I would ever use in the lone striker position. However, because of his characteristics of super aggressive attacking, it could actually work out really nicely with a striker next to him, right? So in a two-striker formation, I could see him working really well too. You don't need to switch the formation to it just to see it. Like, it's his characteristics will allow him to play that way anyway, so it's not really necessarily a huge deal. But yeah, lone striker, he's going to be too small to have up there in all fairness. But anyways, we're going to be using the instruction of, I would say, balanced. Just cover center. I want to play him on the left position just because of him being right-footed with a 4-star weak foot. So let's see if he attacks at least a little bit now. Nicely done, Fuez. Let's go. There we go. Nice little goal there with Neymar. That's why Neymar is one of the most meta players in the game. Alright guys, so final verdict on the Fuenzalida card is that this card is definitely a foot card. He's really freaking good. But give him the sniper, boys. You need these four dribbling stats to be improved, regardless of the 5'7" height that he has. Now, if you use him in the attacking areas, the body type is not an influential thing. And it's actually kind of nice to have on the sides because of how responsive he'll be, especially with those dribbling stats that he already has, right? The +15 for finishing is obviously something that you need on the card as well. The 5'7" height is not influenced by him in game in the attack because of the body type that he has. High work rates are brilliant on this card, especially on the balance instructions in the left and right attack mid positions, because it's a nice balance to have a person that can attack and come back really, really nicely. Like, this is definitely 100% a foot card, and you guys should definitely do this gameplay objective, because honestly, I see him being used as a super sub even, because even if you take off these stats, you know, he's still pretty decent, right? On the, I think, what is it that they get? Like a 5 chemistry boost or something, which is just his base card stats, right? So it's a very good card. If you can somehow start him in your team in the right mid position because you have all the chemistry links in regards to having, I don't know, you have, like, let's just say, for instance, you have, wow, I can't even think of his name right now, Zambrota's card in the right back position, and you have like a legend that you can link up in the cam spot for a 4-5-1 or something like that. He's just a really, really fun card to use, guys. He's definitely a foot card. You guys will notice that difference in game when you try him out, especially with the 10 chem sniper chemistry style on him, okay? Hopefully you guys enjoy this review. I'll catch you guys for the next one. Peace out, dudes. Love you guys.